Welcome to the channel, and in this tutorial we will see how we can write a C program to display this pattern that you guys are seeing on the screen. Now the first thing that we do here is we will divide this pattern in terms of rows and columns. And before that, if you look at the number of rows present in this pattern, total number of rows is equal to 5. Now we can divide this pattern in terms of rows and columns. So we can say this is the first row, second row, third row, fourth row, and fifth row. And similarly, we can say first column, second column, third column, fourth column, and fifth column. Here we are dividing this pattern in terms of rows and columns for our convenience. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start counting the row number in reverse order. So I'm gonna say this is the first row, second row, third row, fourth row, and fifth row. We are just counting from the reverse order. So we can say that the first row will have the row number which is equal to the total number of rows present in this pattern. If we're gonna extend this pattern for, let us say, 10 rows, then, you know, if you start counting like the way I'm doing here, then the first row will have the row number which is equal to 10. So the first row number will have the row number which is equal to total number of rows present in this pattern. Now how we are going to print this pattern is we print it line by line. What I mean by that is first we will print whatever the number of stars that we have to print in the first line or first row, in this case 5. Then we go to the next line and we print whatever the number of stars that we have to print, like this. And then we go to the next line or next row, and similarly we will continue and we will finish the pattern. Now we have to come up with a logic which will calculate the number of columns or number of stars that we have to display for a particular row. If you look at this pattern, then we can easily say that the number of stars that we have to print for a particular row is actually equal to row number. In order to come up with a simple logic like this, I started at the count in this reverse order. So we can say here that if the row number is 5, then we have to display 5 stars or 5 columns in that particular row. Similarly, if the row number is 3, then we have to display 3 stars. So by using this logic, we can calculate the number of stars that we have to display for a particular row easily, and we can display the pattern. Now, let us see how we can implement this logic. Now here what I have done is I have included stdio.h header file to our program so that we can use the functions like printf and scanf. And then we have the main function which will be the entry point of our program from our perspective. So the first thing that we do here is we will declare the variables that we need. We need a variable here for storing the number of rows present in this pattern. I'm going to take integer type of variable and I'm going to say numRows, and I'm going to initialize that with a value of 0. Now after that we can ask the user to enter the number of rows for which he wants the pattern. So I'm going to use the printf function in here and I'm going to say enter the total number of rows, and after that we can read the value entered by the user and we can store that in this numRows variable. So we will use the scanf function and we will read the value by using format specifier %d and we will store it in this numRows variable. Okay, here with this ampersand symbol we are providing the address of this numRows variable because the scanf function requires the address of the variable to work properly. Now we know for how many rows we have to display this pattern, we can print the pattern. So what we do is we will use a loop. I'm going to take a for loop, and this for loop will be for the rows. It will calculate the number of rows or number of lines and it will provide that. So here I'm going to take a variable. I'm going to call it as row. And as I said before, in this pattern, we will count the row number in reverse order. So here the first row we'll have the row number, which is equal to total number of rows present in this pattern. Here we have the total number of rows value in this numRows variable, so we will use that. We will start the row number from whatever the number of rows the user has entered, and after that how many rows we want. Since we are starting the count in reverse order, we will form the condition like, as long as this row variable contains a value which is greater than or equal to 1, we want to run this for loop. That's because here if we look at it, then the row number starts from the total number of rows, and then with every iteration it decrements, and the final value is 1. And after that we will decrement the value of this row variable with every iteration. So what we get here for this row number, we can see that by using a printf function. I'm going to use the printf function in here, and I'm going to display the value of this row variable, which will get the row number. I'm going to save this program and I'm going to run this code. I'm going to say total number of rows 6. Then you guys can see row number starts from 6 and up to 1. But if you look at this, every row number is displayed in a single line. So what we have to do is we have to make sure that every row appears in a separate line. So here I'm going to use the printf function, and I'm going to insert a new line by using this slash n. And here what we're doing is we are inserting this new line after printing the contents for a particular row. Okay, so after printing the contents for a particular line or a particular row, we are adding a new line. So next when we try to print something, it will appear in a separate line. Now if I save this program and if I run this code, and if I say 8 rows, then you guys can see row number starts from 8 up to 1, and every row is appearing in a separate line. So now what we have to do is, for every row, we have to calculate the number of star or number of columns that we have to print, and we have to print them. So in this code, I'm gonna remove this printf function, which actually displays the row number. So since the number of columns that we have to print for a particular row differs, it will vary. We can use a for loop, which will calculate the number of columns that we have to print, and it will print them. And since this for loop is for column, I'm going to take a variable and I'm going to call it as column, which will actually contain the column number. And we can start the column number from 1, and how many columns that we want to print for a particular row. If we look at this calculation, then we can say that the number of columns that we have to print for a particular row is actually equal to row number. So here row number is available in this row variable. So we can form the condition like, as long as this column variable contains a value which is less than or equal to row, we want to run this for loop. So what happens here is this calculation will provide us whatever the row number is, that many columns. Okay, with every iteration we will increment the value of this column variable. So now what we can do is we can display the value of this column variable. So I'm going to use the printf function in here, and I'm going to say percentage %d, and we will display this column variable's value. If I save this program and if I run this code, and if I say 9 rows, now you guys can see the pattern has been displayed. In every column we are displaying the column number. And to make this pattern look pretty, I will add a space after printing the column number. Save the program, run it. I'm gonna say 9. Now you guys can see this pattern looks pretty good. Now here, we can display whatever we want. If you want, you can display row number. If you want, you can display the numbers depending on some calculations, or you can display a symbol. For example, I'm gonna display star, and we don't need the column variable. Save the program, run this code, and I'm gonna say 12 rows. Now you guys can see the pattern looks like this. Okay, so this is how we can write a simple C program to display the pattern. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, do subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.